So Eileen, sometimes patients and their families get a little confused or frightened by the idea of being randomized and ask, what am I being randomized to? What is the standard of care? Is there a placebo? Is there a chance I'm going to get nothing? How do you clarify those issues with them?
Yeah, I agree. These are very common points that need clarification. So explain that randomization is a very common example, as we have two groups of people in a study, and that neither the person themselves, the participant, or the physician or the medical team can choose which group they're going to be assigned to. That's done by computer allocation, very typically, and often it's a one-to-one, so it's like a flip of a coin, a 50-50 chance that they'll get one group or another. And related to that, the topic of whether they're blinded, whether they're getting a placebo comes up. And perhaps a point to note that a lot of trials that we do, and perhaps most trials that we do, don't have placebos in oncology. A lot do, particularly in the later stages where we're really trying to pin down exactly the merits, but often they don't. To help support the development of new drugs, we have to have a reference, and that reference is called a standard approach or standard of care. And for example, in frontline treatment of pancreas cancer, we would let people know that the two main standards that we use would be combinations of drugs such as FOLFIRINOX, which is 5-FU, oxaliplatin, irinotecan, and leucovorin. That's one standard. Another commonly utilized standard would be gemcitabine and nab-paclitaxel. And they have different limitations, different side effects. They may be a better fit for one person versus another, but they're both part of standards of care. And often a study, for example, will build on one or other of those standards and add a new medication to that. And that would be a very common type of trial that we would do for people with newly metastatic pancreas cancer, for example.
Right. So a common design, as you mentioned, would be the standard of care arm would be gemcitabine plus nab-paclitaxel plus placebo. But I emphasize in that case, they are getting at the very least a gold standard of treatment for their disease. Or the experimental arm would be the gemcitabine plus nab-paclitaxel plus the novel drug of interest. I think a couple other points worth mentioning. We talk about randomization being typically a one-to-one randomization. Sometimes for more complex study designs, there might be three or more different arms. Typically, if there are two arms, it's a 50-50 chance. For some studies, they might have more patients enrolled to one arm than another. Patients will often ask, well, if I'm randomized to the standard of care arm, do I have an option of receiving the experimental agent at a later time? And that's an element in a clinical trial called crossover design. And some studies incorporate that, where if you're on the standard or the reference arm and at a point where you're no longer responding to that, sometimes you will then be able to be crossed over to the experimental arm. But sometimes studies don't allow that. So that's another important thing that is worth asking, that is usually described in the consent form.